Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. I'm sorry we're running just a tad late today. We had a few technical difficulties, which I think we have, at least for the moment, solved. So you can actually see the organ, and that's good. Welcome. We hope you had a wonderful Holy Week and Easter. Missed being with you last week. We were plenty busy here, for sure. But we're glad to be back in person and have concerts starting up again for this rest of the spring season. We have Compline this Sunday night at 8 o'clock. If you haven't been to Compline at Grace, it's really beautiful. Half an hour or so service. Lots of candlelight and chant. Very relaxing and beautiful. And you can certainly park in the parking lot if you want to join us at 8 o'clock on Sunday night. And on Sunday, May 1st, a week from this Sunday, at 4 p.m., Collegium Ancora, which is our chamber choir in residence, will be presenting a spring concert called Isn't It Romantic? And it's music of part songs of Brahms, Mendelssohn, and Rheinberger. Really beautiful. If you like music about birds and trees and flowers and love and streams and moon and sun, this is for you. So it should be a delightful concert. That's on May 1st, and there's information on the website about how to get tickets, or you can get tickets at the door. We're always happy to have your donations to help us sustain the series. There's a little offering box near the baptismal font. And if you haven't signed up for our email list, you can do that at the back on the right-hand side. There's a list there, and we'll send you music updates about events at Grace. We're so delighted to welcome Janet Yieh today from New York City, all the way from New York City. Janet I've been honored to call her a friend and colleague for some years now, and she has just been appointed the music director and organist at Church of the Heavenly Rest on Fifth Avenue and 90th Street in New York City, and it's such an exciting chapter for that church and for Janet as they begin what I'm sure is going to be a long and successful relationship there. But we're so happy that she was willing to travel north and share some music with us today. So please give a very warm welcome to Janet Yieh.
Thank you. Hello, everyone, and thanks again so much to Grace Church here in Providence for having me here for this recital. It's a real pleasure to be here. The first piece that you heard on the program is a prelude based on the theme of a tune commonly paired with the hymn, Be Thou My Vision, by New York City composer Jerry Hancock, who for many years was a legendary director of music and organist at St. Thomas Church on Fifth Avenue. The program that I've prepared for you today combines a couple different themes and a couple different, hopefully familiar tunes. At the end of the program, you'll hear a bookending the concert, two more pieces that are based on hymn tunes. One, His Eyes on the Sparrow, arranged by American composer Carl Haywood, and an homage à Pachelbel, which is 10 variations on Lobed and Heron, the tune that's commonly paired with Praise to the Lord, by Krista Rokic, who's a fantastic composer and professor of organ. What you'll hear now is a set of two pieces by Parisian composer Charles-Marie Vidor. He's somebody that you may know from the Vidor Toccata, which is often played on Easter. These two pieces are on the opposite musical spectrum from that boisterous piece. The first is a Sicilienne from a set of six pieces that he called Bach's Memento. He wrote these pretty late in his career, around 1925, and these six pieces are all transcriptions and arrangements of pieces that Bach wrote for harpsichord and other instruments other than the organ. And this is taken after a flute sonata that Bach wrote. The piece you'll hear directly following that is the Andante Sostenuto from his ninth organ symphony, 9 out of 10 symphonies that he wrote, about 30 years earlier in 1895. So a quiet movement with double pedal that comes from his Symphony Gothique. And then after that, you'll hear a piece by Samuel Coleridge Taylor. He self-described himself as an Anglo-African composer. He was a student of Charles Villiers Stanford at the Royal College of Music, and a beautiful little piece called the Arietta in the center. So thanks again for coming. It's great to be here, great to have the people watching online, and I hope you enjoy the recital.